pocket full of pink 50s, right pocket got blues in it. Love send them packs to me, I know what to do with it. $1,000 shoe, I'm walking on a damn out. He ain't running up a bag, he running his damn mouth. I'm Mr. Swinger Dope, Mr. Beat the Road.
Day 3. Hope has not let us out of this room.
He doesn't feed us, he doesn't like do anything, bro. We just been trapped in here just doing the news for y'all. Like,
the only thing we get is new clothes.
Yeah, that's all.
I haven't showered. I'm tired.
I miss my family, y'all.
Let me go.
Help us, please.
I know you're getting sick of us, but I'm Pete.
I'm Evan.
We're almost through the first week of Tri 3 and the first week of spring sports practice. Not feeling too bad considering spring break was just 2 days ago. Gosh, I miss my bed.
Since we've only got a little over a week left in March, we're going to keep it rolling with the Women's History Highlights put together by Strong Women of Tomorrow. Today, Grace Schilling is dealing the goods on the one and only Eleanor Roosevelt.
Eleanor Roosevelt was the longest-serving First Lady in America, serving from 1933 to 1945 following the Great Depression. She took her role of First Lady way past any expectations. She took a leading role in the writing of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which helped people gain the right to vote. She also worked with the NAACP to help African Americans gain rights and was the first lady to ever hold an all-female press conference. She joined the Women's Trade Union League and became an active member in the New York Democratic Party. She was cheated on by her husband, Franklin Roosevelt, and their marriage got complicated. Nevertheless, she was deemed the first lady of the world and she died at 78 years old by stroke.
Dang! Didn't realize Eleanor was the first lady of the world.
For real.
Thanks for that, Gracie. While not nearly as special as holding an all-female press conference, stepping on the stage as class of 2024's graduation speaker is a pretty big deal. And you've only got one more day to sign up. Come on, seniors. Tryout signups open Tuesday and end tomorrow. This is a once-in-a-lifetime chance to share your message with all 600 of your classmates. So step up and sign up. The sign-up sheet is in the counseling office, and you can check in with Mr. Lackinen with any questions.
By this time, seniors, you shouldn't have any more questions about how to submit your photos and videos for the senior video. Get them in, y'all. The deadline is coming up fast, Wednesday, April 24th, so get your stuff turned in. Also, you can get your senior all-night party form turned in by scanning the QR code on the screen.
Tonight, the following clubs take place. Tornado Force, Asian Club, Avid Club, K-Pop, and Tornado Tales Book Club. And tomorrow morning at 6 a.m., they'll have the net set up for some pickleball. You going to there?
Yeah, waking up at 6, maybe.
We'll see. Also happening today, Anoka's sending one of their choirs to the Treble Choir Festival. Ooh, wow.
For lunch, the cafeteria dishes out crispy chicken salad, turkey and cheese croissants, and spicy meatballs. It's not as good as a glizzy day, right, Pete?
Of course.
Now that you know it's on the menu, let's turn it over to sports.
All right, let's start with a send-off to the speech team who is competing in the section tournament this afternoon over at Park Center High School. Let's roll some clips.
So, after basic training, Das's regiment deployed to Okinawa, where they fought in close combat with Japanese soldiers atop the infamous 400-foot-tall Hacksaw Ridge. In this storied battle, Das single-handedly saved at least 75 men.
Nothing pairs well together, quite like children's puppet shows and murder.
I love murder!
Sesame. Life on the Street.
By Andrew Murder.
Messer.
By Andrew Messer.
Silence is where I fell apart, and silence is where I put myself back together again. And I don't have to be alone in that. For every story like mine, there can be a story like yours too. You can find that peace, that solitude, and that strength.
Dumb vote, your ignorant vote, your wasted vote.
Ah, I'm sick of these dogs, always tearing up my underwear. I don't even know they got into that, but whatever. I gotta get rid of these miscreants.
The pecan pie tastes like sticky chalk. Hard to swallow, I chew slowly. Try to calm myself. My doctor says, no more losing my temper. I'm far too old to afford anger.
More coffee or another slice of pie?
Could kill her. I could pour syrup down her throat till she drowns.
There's no guidebook. There is no etiquette. There are no rules. All we have are these musty old expectations, cliches based large in part in literature and movies.
Bring your A game, Speechies. And for all of you signed up for a spring sport, keep bringing your energy. Last night, the girls' golf team was hitting into the net, track and field was running drills in the gym, lacrosse was on the practice field, and softball and baseball kept things indoors. It was a busy night of practice, and it looks the same tonight.
There are more spring sports gearing up for the season soon. For boys interested in trying out for the golf team that missed our meeting the other day, information on tryouts is located in the Decamart.
The trap and skeet team will hold their new shooter day on March 28th at Minnetonka Fish and Game Club, while their first official practice is April 4th with competing competitions starting on April 25th, at which point they'll be shooting every Thursday at 3:30 p.m. until May 30th.
The boys' tennis season starts March 25th at the courts and registration is open. Please attend the player-parent meeting tonight at the high school cafeteria at 6 p.m. This is a great team that is super fun, welcoming, and very competitive. We do not cut. All you need are tennis shoes and a racket. We will go over how and where to get a racket at the parent meeting too. Please let Coach Bertram know if you have any questions. That's all for sports. Take it away, Pete.
Oh, I'm real sore from the throw practices. Hey, Evan, I heard Coach say you're gonna run the 3200.
Huh? 3200? He didn't tell me nothing about that.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm gonna stick with my sprints.
All right. The wind is picking up for spring sports, but the weather forecast isn't looking helpful. I thought we were done with all this snow and cold.
Yeah, I guess not, man. Looks like we're going to get hit with some heavy snow on Sunday. I knew it was too good to be true when it was 60 in January. I knew it wasn't going to last. That's all we got today. We're going to close out the show with some videos from the spring sports practices this week. I'm Evan.
And I'm President P. Stay spinning, tornadoes!
Yeah, oh, shoot.